Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Olathe District Activities Center for today's Heart of America Athletic Conference match between the Clarke University Pride and the MNU Pioneers. I am MNU Sports Information Director Chad Jenkins. I will be bringing you the action today, doing the live stats, running the music, coordinating the replay, running the video streaming, and being an all-around gentleman of leisure. I had the records in front of me, but now I've... Okay, here we go. Clarke is 10-6-1 overall, 6-4-1 in the heart. MNU is 5-9-1, 5-5-1 in conference play. I probably should have checked the standings and whatnot before all this. I've got the world's worth of information at my fingertips. I'll just do that now. Starting for Clarke, Brindley Ward, Shannon Ketcher, Genevieve Cruz, I think I said her name wrong in the intro, Morgan Ketcher, Sophia Morales, Jamie Albertson, Carly Gilling, Zoe Framke, Avery Abbas, Maya Johnson, and Addie Seaman, coaches Josh Prince. Oh, I'm running the clock, too, with the scoreboard. Starting for the Pioneers, Kaylee Barnhart in goal. Renee Barak, Ichi Rodriguez, Rihanna Reed, Elvia Villagomez, Alyssa Ward, Trinity Jones, Anita Harris, Grayson Cloth, Morgan Hill, and Emily Carrasco. Clarke coming here on the far side. I'm very far away. I can't see who people are. This is number 7. Cruz. Took me long enough to find that. And Clarke controls again. I like Clark's uniforms they got going. Big, bright numbers on a dark background. Clarke is in navy and gold. Pioneers are in navy and white with red accents. We're at ODAC today. This is where we play football behind us at a different field. Our field took on 3-4 days of constant rain. And everything here was booked yesterday, so we had to move it to Sunday. We don't like to play on Sundays at MNU. It takes very special circumstances for this to happen. It's only happened a half a dozen times in 15 of my years or so. This is threaded through to Alyssa Jones, broken up. Alyssa Jones, that's not her name. Ward from Trinity Jones. That was broken up by 21, Framke. Anna Harris kicks that out. Good to see her back on the pitch after her scary moment a few weeks ago. Carted off in an ambulance with some crazy muscle spasms that were so bad that we thought it was appendicitis and had to get her out of there. Turned over in the corner. Here comes the Pride trying to get to the middle. Shot by, I think that's Cruz. Goes high. Thank you. streaming, right? I'm seeing a black screen on YouTube. Let me know in the chat if we're all good. Okay, we're all good. Senior day for the Pioneers today. That's a shot on goal from four. Shannon catcher. Whoops. We'll have senior day festivities afterwards. That's going to be a foul on Morgan Hill. Why is my clock stopped? Struggling, folks. This is why you can't do it all yourself. It's a handball. She was looking directly into the sun. Lost it in the sun. It bounced in front of her and hit her in the elbow. The Pioneers are eighth in the Heart. So right on the cusp there of conference tournament consideration. I think the top eight teams go to the conference tournament. This is Harris. Ward blue attire, but Barack is there. Nobody in the middle. And Clarke takes over. This is Cruz. Shoves Villa Gomez down. No call. It's kept in play, but the Pioneers have it now. Jones over to Barack. Not Barack, Rodriguez. Now Barack. Gets it on her right foot. Bryce wants her to hit it. Goes far wide. Goal kick for the Pride. And this is the last game of the regular season for the Pioneers. I don't think we can be caught by William Penn, so I think we're safely into the eight spot for the conference tournament. And then I also don't think we can catch Grandview. What's going on? They have 12 games? Yeah, they're already done. So I think MNU is in the eight spot regardless. Let me know if I'm wrong about that. Clarke, on the other hand, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They're sixth in the conference, and they could catch Baker depending on how they did against them. And they could also drop below Grandview, depending on how they did against them. But that's a between 5, 6, and 7, depending on the outcome of this one. So it looks like the Pioneers are headed to Central Methodist for the conference tournament next week. Carrasco shoots it wide. Pioneers getting some shots. CMU has been a tough draw, to say it lightly. They're 16-1. Overall, 12-0 in conference. And they've been thumping people. But it is soccer. You can dominate and still lose 1-0. Maybe we'll get one of those. Or maybe we'll dominate. This is catcher into the middle for Cruz. Carrasco is there to break it up, and Hill going the other way. Sends it upfield. If someone is yelling Mark Up or Morgan. It's a beautiful day in Olathe. Chilly, very windy. Clock stoppage here. Morgan is what he's yelling. He wants Morgan to come here. They want to talk to the whole team. So this is Cat Shannon, catcher, who went down hard. No foul was called. The ref is talking to the coach right now about why not. If the foul had been called, it would have been in the box. So sometimes they don't want to call those unless it's blatantly obvious. I think that one may have been able to qualify. I don't know why he didn't call it. This is the ref that looks like character actor Leland Orser. You'll recognize him if you look up Leland Orser, but you won't remember exactly where you've seen him unless you're a cinephile, which I just exposed myself to be. Small parts in Saving Private Ryan, Pearl Harbor, 7. Looks like this ref. He's coming over to talk to the AR, asking maybe should I have called that foul, or it was close, I don't know. It looked like the players like collided hips. So she may have gotten the wind knocked out of her. They're working her knee and hip joints. It's a pretty good collision. Grayson Cloth just gave her a handshake and a pat on the back. Maybe it was her who collided with her and got the better end of that one, frankly. Did they replace her? 28. Is that a new player? Nope. She's just stepping off for a moment. She'll come back on. No sub. And we're back in play. Go ahead. Barack working that far side. Out of bounds, and Trinity Jones throws it in. Too heavy of a touch, and it's turned over. I'm going to sneeze in a second. Some confusion between Jones and Barack, and that results in a turnover. No one to pass it to. Pioneers still have it, though. Via Gomez from the point. Is that what it's called in soccer? More of a hockey term. Corner for the Pioneers. There you go. Get that zoom working. Via Gomez, and the wind is blowing towards the goal, so she'll have to. That's not Via Gomez. What in the world? That was Cloth. Via Gomez sends that in, headed in the box. I am not sure that I have ever seen somebody else take a corner when Via Gomez is on the field. Maybe Briley Johnson a couple years ago. Pioneers having a hard time corralling the ball on this surface. Used to playing on grass. The ball doesn't scoot quite as easily. Every touch seems to be a little bit out of control. Abbas with it. Sent ahead trying to find Cruz. Harris breaks it up. Ref says no foul as Ward gets shoved. And she's now limping. See how serious that is. Nope, she can't continue with the press. She's bending over at midfield and now she takes a seat. As soon as this attempt is thwarted, we'll have a whistle and a clock pretty soon. Well, Award's back up, trotting now. Pioneers get a foul. looks fine again. Barak shoots it over to Rodriguez. Get it on the right foot. Can't quite do it. Carrasco in the middle, tries to thread it through the defense, and it's cleared off to the side. Ichi, Ward. Back to Harris. Tries to find Jim Smith. But he's not an official participant. Goal kick. Off to Harris. Carrasco wide to Jones. Cruz now for Clarke. Working with Morales on the far side. Now back to Cloth. Carrasco now, taken away. Here comes the pry the other way. Cruz to Morales. She and Carrasco say some words, and then she kind of kicked Carrasco and tripped her. I saw that. Comes out. Harris is there to clear. So watch for Carrasco and Cruz. They're getting a little chippy already. Hill, that's still our ball. Ward working on Johnson. Johnson able to turn it around. Ward steals it, however, gets it right back. Carrasco in the middle, one more to Barak. She chips it into the middle. Oh, Ward couldn't collect it. Still in the middle, still unable to be cleared. Ward shoots that, and it's blocked away for a corner. And is this... This is Cloth again. Into the middle. Touches no one. Nice shot from Cloth and a nice save from the keeper. And that'll be another corner. Cloth sends it in. And headed out by Clarke. So another corner for the Pioneers. And it's Carrasco, again, not Villa Gomez, regardless of which side it is. Very interesting. Into the middle, headed away. Morales clears. Harris steps in front of catcher, who's back in. Clock. .17 with a card. Must have said something. The ref snapped at her. Foul. Clarke. Yellow. Clarke, 17. Jamie Albertson. A little bit of dissent. Most likely. Clock back in on the whistle. Sent in low. Pioneers still have it. This is Jones on the far side. Ahead to Villa Gomez. Sends it into the middle. And the Pioneers earn another corner. It out of bounds. Trinity Jones to Barack to Villa Gomez into the middle. Ward right there. They can't find it. It's cleared. Uh-oh. Oh, catcher is still really hurting. She couldn't participate in that play. And that could have been a breakaway if she was 100%. They're just going to kick it out of bounds. Stop the clock. .22:56 is where we are. That stinks. One of their top players, no doubt. Shannon Catcher. That front line. Replaced by number 16, Hannah Sikora. Rodriguez in the middle. A little too much. streaming in glorious 1080p. If you've got a big screen TV or something, fire it up. We can never do this with soccer because the internet at our field isn't strong enough for that, but out here it is. Barack. Why is this camera so shaky? Might need to tighten that up. Work on that at halftime. The ball hasn't been on this side of the field in quite a while. Yeah, foul on Trinity Jones right outside the box. This will be dangerous. Sakura taking this. Wow, headed away. And this will be a corner for Clarke. Sakura again. Out of bounds, no threat. Check, check. I'll turn down the crowd mic as we've got guys sitting right under this one. Harris battling. Throw in for Clarke down in that corner. Is that Chipotle that he's bringing up? That sounds like a good idea. Big throw into the middle, cleared momentarily by Villa Gomez. Albertson shot from deep into the middle, cleared. A couple of the Pride players were each one step behind that. Really good chance there. Get there. Into the middle. In the middle again. Cloth is there. Reed clears and Rodriguez sends it back out. Villa Gomez trying to get it to Ward. Not quite, but Pioneers get it back. Foul on Clarke. Could have gone either way as they were battling. Clock. She's trying to walk it off. Doesn't look very good. That's Albertson. Might need to be subbed out. I mean, she's hobbling like a someone who hobbles a lot. Couldn't think of a good appropriate analogy there. Simile. Hobbling like an injured soccer player. Barack feeds the middle. Carrasco now gets it on the left foot over to Morgan Hill into the middle. Nice try. Pioneers getting good pressure in this one early as the wind in their favor. Keeper launches this one. Rodriguez with it. Into the corner. Right through the legs. Out of bounds. Pioneers will have a throw-in down here. Harris towards the middle. Trinity Jones now. Out to Cloth. In the middle to Villa Gomez. She'll try to put one on frame, and she does, but not much of a threat. I think I'd want to throw it in my own corner, but that's what the Pioneers have elected to do. I'm trying to get it out, and they can't. Yeah, that's dangerous. Carrasco breaks a little bit free, sends it ahead to Barack, over to Cloth. Sends it in. It's up for grabs in the middle, settled by Ichi. Carrasco Carrasco fires wide. Hill into the middle, knocked away. Corner for the Pioneers. Carrasco. We've lost focus. Into the middle, knocked away. Carrasco fires again. That's blocked. Zoom into midfield to get focus. There you go. Sometimes these turf fields confuse the camera with different reflections and glares than they're used to seeing. Turned over. Hill fighting to get it back with Sakura. This is Haley Huxdorf with it. When did she sneak into the game? Number 10 came out. Founder. Nice. Cloth from about 35 yards. Barack left foot. Wide. Another sub. 17 off and 2 on. foul on, even a handball on Anita. Seven minutes. Nice ball in, headed towards the goal, but out of bounds. That was Addie Seaman with that launch. This will be Seaman again, firing from, what do you think, 40, 35? Against the wind, it holds up, and fired from the middle there by number 8, Morgan Catcher. But it was right at Barnhart. A foul on Ward. Pretty nice takedown. Could hear Villa Gomez right there yelling out, "You can't call that her foul." That was not Ward, it was Barack actually with the takedown. Looked pretty mutual from here, but he chose to go with Clarke. Trying to sneak it through to Ichi, but broken up a little bit. Hill working against Huxdorf. Pioneers will have a throw-in deep into their own territory. Or Clarke territory, I don't know. Their own offensive side. Harris now, Anita, shoots it on ahead. And it's coming back the other way. Huxdorf gets hip-checked into the turf. And he didn't call that foul, just gave him the throw-in. Okay. It's too cold to blow this whistle. I don't care. It's their ball anyway. Keeps it in bounds, actually. Off the face of Hill. And it's Pioneer ball. It was pretty advantageous. Watch a score on this because of that now. Keeps it through. Now Barack is out front. Not going to beat the keeper there, though. But the Pioneer is still threatening the throw-in down there. I think Harris was just trying to clear it, but it went off Morgan's face, stayed in bounds, and the Pioneers had it. Now Clarke coming the other way. Barack now to Jones. Pioneers with some space, some speed. Nice shot from Ward off the post. Two opportunities for Ward right there. Save, and then she shot again off the post. And then a foul was called on MNU. Got it. I've got this replay here. Let's see what we got. next time we have a stoppage. Here's this replay. Check out Ward's work here. Wow. A really nice try. Under 2 minutes to play. And a sub for Clarke at an interesting time. 22 comes in. Seven comes off. That's a nice idea from Clarke. Take 30 seconds off the clock here, as the Pioneers have been threatening. May as well take time off while you're against the wind. And Huxdorf to the middle. Trinity Jones there to thwart that attempt. 43 is in the game. Reese Castanon. I missed that one too. Ooh. Foul on Clarke. Oh, I forgot to say 1 minute. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, zero. Fifteen. Halftime for Olathe. Scoreless. We'll be back in 15 minutes. about to start the second half. Check, check. Try to get these subs correct. Tenna's back in. So I need to take somebody out. 16 out there. Clark getting good pressure out wide right away with the wind now. And they get an immediate corner kick. Nice ball in, out of bounds though. A little too much, the Pioneers will throw it in. Gomez with tons of space. Rodriguez has some buddies with her. Ward. Rodriguez sends it into the middle. Only Clarke there. Cloth. Another deep shot trying to find Ward. And Ward pushes off and collects a foul. Some more pushing. Ward and Albertson getting into it. After the foul, Albertson gave Ward a little shove, and Ward was like, okay. We'll see. not one to let that go. I wouldn't mess with either one of them. Clean play. Ball goes out. Goal kick. Into the middle. Deep throw in for Addie Seaman. I bet she can throw it half as far as she can kick it. She'll be all right. Rodriguez to the middle. Finds Morgan Hill by herself on the left side. She makes a move, sends it to the middle. Trinity Jones is there, but broken up by the Pride. Yeah, foul on 28. A little forearm shiver. From Abbas and Pioneers. We'll have Carrasco over the ball. And against the wind, you can try for the, you can get it up high over the keeper's hands, but a little too much. Ward, Brinley Ward, is pretty tall back there. Couple of connected passes if the Pioneers moving forward. This is Barak. Another foul on Clarke, I think. Knocked away by Framke. Pride have numbers. Reed able to turn back upfield without kicking it out of bounds. I always love that play. Jeez. Cloth. That's not cloth. That's, is that 16? 11. That's wrong the whole time. That's not Reyes. That's. That is definitely 16. Am I crazy? Do you know Grayson Clough by sight?
Yeah.
That's her, right?
Yeah.
She's wearing the wrong number. 16. She's 15. Not on my stats. On ahead, Pioneers are onside. Ward can't get through. So I was wrong in my assessment, by the way, of the Pioneers being locked into the 8 seed. Foul. If the Pioneers win this game, they jump Clarke, as it turns out. They would have the same record, but MNU would have the tiebreak, obviously, if they win this game. So MNU would move to the 7. Which would get them out of Central Methodist, which is a good idea. Two seed will still be a tough matchup, but CMU is clearly head and shoulders above everybody else this year. It would be Benedictine, where the Pioneers have had success historically, despite Benedictine being ranked higher most of those years. Turned into a decent, tough chance. It wasn't even a shot. Pioneers have to win, actually, not just tie or anything, to get out of the 8 seed. And if Clarke loses, they move to the 8 seed, and their travels would be to CMU. Rock. He's got Hill and Ward. 3 against 4. Trinity Jones coming for support. Let it rip. Blocked away. And a nice clear by the Pride defense. Turnover. Pioneers recover. Throw in for the Pride. sent back into the box. Nobody there for the Pride, though. Ref says play on. Headed just wide. Turned over. Clarke. Carrasco trying to work it upfield. Rock up to Trinity Jones. The Pioneers can start to move. Gets past her, but fakes herself out. Puts that ahead to Rodriguez. Broken up. Rock. Yeah, gets taken out. And the Pioneers will be dangerous from here. If we score, clock and rejoice. Carrasco over the ball. She's got a four-man wall working. Four-person wall. Four-woman wall. Four-player wall. That works the best. Gets it through and a goal! What a shot from Emily Carrasco. Glances off the wall and the Pioneers take a lead. Here it is again. Keeper was on it, but then it changed direction. Let's try that again with slow motion this time. Clock back in. Up the sideline, Ward gets shoved into the chain link fence. Eventually, she's going to get sick of that. She's got a few yellows this year. She's been known to fight back a little bit. This AR wants to talk to the ref and say that was a pretty good shove. a yellow wouldn't be ridiculous. It's kind of dangerous being that close to the fence. Ref says, all right, I got you. And this is cloth, we think, even though she's wearing 16. Nice ball into the middle, headed up by Clarke. Ward gets ahead on that one. And it became dangerous, but saved nonetheless. Finds Carrasco, but it's broken up. Carrasco pulling a jersey, going to get that foul, yep. Handball, that was a little far down the arm. Well, Alyssa Gladhart's in the game. When did that happen? How are these people sneaking in? Who came off? Via Gomez is over there stretching. What was I doing? Maybe that happened during the goal. Foul on Ward, and I heard from the bench, how many? Other teams like to do that when one player starts racking up fouls. Most of the time they're way wrong. Barnhart there crushes somebody. Wow. That looked like a punch to the ear. I got that on replay, too. Let's see what happened there. Pioneers will have a throw-in, but here is that replay. Barnhart clearing more than the ball. Oh! Oh, my gosh. Good thing she hit the ball first, or that would have been a PK. Get out of my area. Morgan Hill got some space. That's got to be a corner. Ooh. Only I thought so. Never mind. Middle. Cloth gets there to break up that chance. Gladhart tries to move it up. That's turned over. Chipped on ahead. Ward, after a mistake by the defender. Framke let that get by her. Offsides. Offside. Nice try, though. All the people in the crowd yell at the ref, but couldn't explain offsides if you asked them to. Clarke. Ward slid in there pretty hard. Looks like they both took a shot. Ward is up. Keeper. You gotta try to put weight on that right foot. Not happening. She's asking for a foul, and the ref is saying something she doesn't like, probably. Let me fix this bow real quick. We got the camera on her? Yep. Seaman will take this goal kick while Brinley Ward, it was the two Wards colliding there. Alyssa came away with the better of it. Two subs. Clarke. No. 22 and 9. Remember who goes out for me, though. 22. 10. Ann Crawford replaced Jilling, and Faith Bauer replaced Morales. It's a goal kick, nicely, smartly played out by Cloth. Uh-oh, turnover. 3-on-1, shot from deep. 7 with that shot. Genevieve. Cruz with that shot. Carrasco getting pinballed around between two Pride members. Morgan Hill. Ward ahead to Jones. They will have a chance here. Trinity. Oh, it curls wide. That took a sharp left. Wow. How did that miss? Here it is again. Look at this thing just skitter left. Zoop. Rock getting sandwiched, and he calls a foul. Ref says, go ahead. Pioneers say, we'll take that foul. He said, play on. Bryce is arguing his case with the AR. Gladhart fighting far side. Pass gets deflected. Ichi comes in, cleans that up. Clarke now working the offensive zone. Broken up. Here come the Pioneers the other way. Barack will just be content to clear this one. Nope. Foul. I disagree. I agree with the player who said I got the ball first. Looked like a pretty good tackle from where I was. Not going to complain too much. Barack left foot broken up. Ball's going to stay in bounds. I was just hugging the line down there, it looked like. The wind has officially changed, and now it's cold. Pride now. Gladhart. Couldn't get it through. Just launch it. There you go. Ward. Couldn't get her footing. Into the middle. Cloth clears momentarily. Ichi clears. Here come the Pioneers. Barack has Ward and Rodriguez. Turned over, though. You know St. John's reading that? Okay. Okay. broken up nicely by the defense, and here comes Villa Gomez the other way. Nope, not Villa Gomez. Ward gets taken down. Clarke are going to get a yellow on that one. Maybe no yellow. Not sure. Yes, yellow on 33. She's the one that got popped in the face. Nope. 12:09 remaining on the clock, on the whistle. Ball does not go very far against the wind today. Clarke trying to get this ball to settle. Cloth finally clears, but Grace, throw in deep in their own offensive zone. It's into the middle. Barack there to clear. Ward now with some speed. Trying to fight through two people. And we've got Jones on the outside. Cruz. Seaman from deep corner. Chested away by Carrasco. Nicely done, but it'll be a corner for the Pride. Did he stop the clock? No, sub. 23 off for 43. That is a weird soccer number. .43 with a corner just into the game. Reese Castanon. Brianna Reed there, chests it down and clears. Sent back in, Barnhard wants it, and we'll take it and knock off. No time at all, get rid of it. That was clean. Number 8 with a shot, blocked by Reed. Ooh, a foul on Hill. Pioneer's clearance attempts will be tough as they're against the wind. And that'll be a corner. 22 with this corner. Pioneers trying to finesse it out. Clarke will throw it in your midfield. Goal kick. Got a sub. Caroline Rutledge comes in for Anna Harris. What did he call? Stop it. I missed whatever just happened. Whistle, clock back in. We're at 6:31 officially. Cruz on frame right into the midsection of Kaylee Barnhard, no problem. Carrasco ahead to Morgan Hill, back to Ichi. Pioneers content to keep possession. Carrasco. Now Ichi loses it. Carrasco gets it right back. Alyssa Gladhart and someone else looked like they knocked shins or knees together, and she's down here in midfield. Whoever Gladhart got tangled up with, I can't see. Clock. That is number 9. And Crawford shaken up. Framke consoling her as she's distraught there on the pitch. Either she knows she's seriously hurt, or sometimes you get that, maybe you get the wind knocked out of you and you're scared for a bit, and then that adrenaline dump and you start freaking out. Happens a lot. She's nodding as he's saying, "Are you good?" And she's like, "I just give me a second." She's moving her ankle. her feet. And walking off on her own power with a heavy limp. I didn't see a sub yet. 17. Coming on for her. Jamie Albertson out. No, in. And Crawford goes out. Clock. We're approaching 5 minutes. The Pioneers can't sub anymore without stopping the clock once we pass 5 minutes. So that's where we pass. So probably these 11 the rest of the way. Clarke out front, broken up momentarily, finally cleared out. Looked like Faith Bauer got a shot on that. Don't let me miss 1 minute again. Kicked down through the other stands here into the vomitorium. The Clarke defense is way sucked forward. They have to retreat now, but once they get the ball down on this end of the field, that defense will come way up and be vulnerable for a quick counter. Barack picks that one up, and Cruz will put it in the box from here. Nope, they elect to build it forward. Maya Johnson working on Ward. And it gets taken away. Here comes Ichi, one on two. Just get it through there. Nope. Barack gets there first. Gladhart coming the other way now. Barnhard comes off her line and collects it. Plenty of room for Morgan Hill on the far side. If she can beat Johnson, she's got a shot. Seconds left. Thank you. 1 minute. 1 minute remaining. Pioneers pick up a foul. With the wind, again, we've said it all game, they'll be dangerous from here. This is number 8, catcher, Morgan catcher. On frame, but Barnhart is there. Seconds left. This should do it. If Trinity Jones can clear this big, that'll be the game. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Good win for the Pioneers on Senior Day. Gets them out of the 8th seed and into the 7th seed for the conference tournament. We'll be going to Benedictine next week. Clarke will be headed to Central Methodist. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. We'll be back for the men's game in 25 minutes. Love you. Stick around for Senior Day stuff. I forgot about that. We'll be starting that right away. Kelvin St. John will be on PA and reading the Senior Day stuff. Go ahead and start that.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'll be honoring this year's seniors. We're going to start with number 6, Ichi Rodriguez from Spain. Her major is nursing. She would like to thank her family, especially her parents. Say it now? We're looking at Bryce or not? Is that thumbs up for us? Sorry, I wasn't at rehearsal. We begin with number 6, Ichi Rodriguez from Spain. Her major is nursing. She would like to thank her family, especially her parents. She said, without them, I wouldn't have been able to live this experience. Also, I want to thank all the coaches I have had during my 4 years at MNU. They made me not only a better player, but a better person. Her favorite soccer memory is being able to play for her team. Her favorite team, Real Betis. Our next player is number 7, Brianna Reed. She's from San Diego, California, also a nursing major. She writes, I would like to thank my parents for pushing me through everything and my teammates for creating a family-like culture and being so welcoming. Her favorite soccer memory was when she was doing the kids camp playing sharks and minnows. She writes, I was the last player and I thought I was going to cross the line when Kaylee came out of nowhere and kicked my ball halfway across the field. Our next player, number 11, Trinity Jones from Bonner Springs, Kansas. Her major is psychology. She would like to thank her parents for sacrificing and providing her with the resources to play the game she has loved for the last 16 years of her life. She says, I will forever be grateful for that. Her favorite soccer memory? My favorite soccer memory is going to Nationals my freshman year with my best friends, or getting sauced up by Bryce McClanahan my freshman year of preseason. Trinity Jones. Anita Harris, number 14. Anita hails from Columbia, not Colorado. Her major is sports management. I'd like to thank my mom, Rocio, dad, Jorge, brother Juan for their support through my soccer career. Their motivation to achieve goals and keep pushing through it all. To my extended family for their interest in my academic and athletic trajectory and their unconditional support. To my new family, the Harrises, for making me feel welcome into their lives and let me pour some soccer in their minds and hearts. Her favorite memory, our trip to Portland freshman year. In all the moments I've made my teammates laugh, especially Ichi, Anita Harris. And number 25, Kaylee Barnhart. She's from Las Vegas, Nevada, a major in criminal justice with a minor in psychology and sociology. I would like to thank my mom and dad for sacrificing so much time and money for me to be able to play soccer. They have continued to push me to be the best person I can be and have given me endless love and support throughout my life. I would also like to thank my family and my boyfriend for always supporting me 100% in my soccer career as well as my time here at MNU. Her favorite memory, winning against Benedictine her sophomore year, Kaylee Barnhart. Let's give him a round of applause. Let's hear it one more time for our graduating seniors. Is that my other?